Now, it's been described as the most significant event in our nation's history, the arrival of Captain James Cook. Now, the government will spend $15 million marking the 250th anniversary later this year, but those events won't hero worship Cook as other anniversaries have in the past. So how should we view Cook in 2019? Whena Owen has this report.
Sailing that death ship around our country is a re-traumatisation.
The establishment would prefer that Cook never existed.
If you throw too many verbal rocks at each other, you can end up throwing real ones if you're not careful.
Still a paradise, 2.5 centuries after Cook's landfall here near this Gisborne city beach. One of the biggest changes over the last century is how we view that arrival.
Growing up here in Gisborne, we are a Cook town, or we have been a Cook town for a very long time, and he does cast a shadow across our community, but we knew who we were as well. But none of that seemed to count for much.
In 1969, 5 navies helped New Zealand celebrate the 200th anniversary of Cook's landing. Gisborne went off.
What happened in 1969 was quite an insult to local Māori, you know. Just being asked to come and do the haka.
Historian Damon Salmond is working with Te Hā, the trust which is organising the East Coast's commemorations of the landing.
All of us involved in this thing are trying to tell all the stories. You know, warts and all, on all sides.
And 50 years on, Gisborne's rangatahi recount the Cook story from the shore.
Captain Cook, when he arrived, he actually set foot on just up the river and had a bad encounter up there.
Now surrounded by reclaimed portland, this is the spot where Cook set foot on Aotearoa.
And while he went up the river to investigate with Solander and Banks, he left 4 guys in charge of the boats here. And you could say that that's when the relationship between Māori and Pākehā first began.
A local rangatira, Te Maro, was the first to be shot by Cook's crew as they approached the strange visitors. Nick Tupara is his descendant.
You can say he would have come down here and then been confronted with Cook's crew. That then unfortunately led to his death.
But this memorial and others will soon tell the story of the 9 Māori who were killed during Cook's visit to the Gisborne area. The famous Cook statue is off to the museum, and the words around the events are carefully chosen.
Te Hā is not a celebration.
At Gisborne's Tairawhiti Museum, Director Eloise Wallace walks us through an exhibition called A View from the Shore.
So this is Robin Kahukiwa.
She says, so this is the truth about Captain James Cook. He should not be celebrated, for he was a crook. His legacy is not the dual heritage about which we do hear. No, it's colonisation, the heavy load that we bear.
Over in Hamilton, John Robson is looking forward to marking Cook's arrival. He heads the International Captain Cook Society.
I believe that most of what Cook achieved and did was positive, and as such, is the word celebration? To a certain extent, I believe it is.
Robson hails from where Cook grew up, came out here because of Cook, writes books about Cook, lectures about him on cruise ships, and is related to him via the captain's sister.
Cook has influenced a great deal of my life.
But he claims the government's cultural institutions are really down on Cook.
One of the passengers on the cruise ship I was on last week had visited Te Papa in Wellington, asked to see Cook things, and was told, if you want that rubbish, go to Australia.
Australia's spending nearly $60 million on its commemorations. From the East Coast, Indigenous rights advocate Tina Ngata is part of a network of Australian and Pacifica people opposing the Cook commemorations. Next week, they'll go to the United Nations, Ngata's second visit, protesting what they see as re-entrenching colonisation.
The Prime Minister should fund lunches in schools. If she is genuinely invested in positive race relations in our country, then she'll pull this up short and say, no, there's some honest conversations we need to have first.
A society that didn't commemorate a moment as important as that would be an odd society. I mean, it'd be a society that was kind of cultivating amnesia. With all of us, you know, as human beings, parts of our history are uncomfortable, but they help to shape us.
And that's Nick Tupada's attitude. Have it all out there. So much so, his family are very obliging when asked to reenact the murder of their ancestor.
Every other year, somebody comes up with a bright idea to do a Captain Cook documentary, and they need Maoris involved in that, and they'll come along here, and generally one of us will get shot and the rest of us will do a haka, and the marae will get a koha. It's been seen to be a little bit of a light-hearted reaction to the whole hero worship of Cook.
But this October, Cook will be just one player in festivities that promote Polynesian voyaging feats. The Endeavour replica will be just one of many vessels.
The last time the Endeavour came to Gisborne, it was like hated by a lot of the people from here just because of what happened when Cook landed.
So how is that going to change? What's going to happen this time?
This time, there'll be a lot of mixed emotions there.
So today is February the 14th.
February the 14th, 1779 was the day on which she died on Hawaii Island. A sad day.
We have a party because that's the day that business was taken care of.
That is fascinating stuff.